guys, it's Jess here from Spolly Syndications and I'm at my local park with Everest. Now, it's the 28th of April 2018 and we decided that this month we're going to dedicate all of our newsletters to National Greyhound Adoption Day, which is tomorrow, the 29th of April. And we thought we could share with you some of the things that we do with your greyhound to ensure that not only is it a really good racer, but it's also be able to be rehomed with no trouble. So Everest here has had some socialisation with Arnie, the Maltese Shih Tzu, who lives with us and has been a pet of ours for the last 10 years. Giving you a wave. And also we have our children, which are around them on a daily basis, which is Isabella.
Hello.
So we've plenty of interaction with them as much as possible from a very, very young age to ensure that the dog is familiar with other people and other dogs. And obviously we encourage you guys to come on up and meet your dog as well. It's really important. Now the other thing that we see as being important is the environment that they live in. So we like to get them out of the paddock as much as we can so that they understand that there's more to this world than just a paddock. So as you would have seen in January, we took the dogs down to the beach and we do that quite regularly in the summer to give them a freshen up. And then the other activity we do is we take them for walks and sometimes we bring them out to places like this, which is our local park. So it just gives them a bit of exposure to being in a trailer, so they have to travel from A to B, which is something they'll have to do when they're racing. It also gives them exposure to different sounds, different people, different lights, different noises, lots of different things that when they get to the track they're also going to have to get used to. It's nice and they're simple things, they're not particularly complicated, but it really does add a lot of confidence to the dog. And confident dogs go on to make much better racing greyhounds. And also, it means that when the time comes for them to retire, which hopefully subject to no injuries, around about four and a half, they can go on to live on somebody's sofa and have a really nice retirement. And you're probably gonna enjoy racing, aren't you, hey? You'll enjoy retirement too. So look, Everest is actually at a really exciting time in her racing training. So Everest will be heading to the Breakers at the end of May. So the next 4 weeks, we'll spend 2 weeks with her on some intense handling to make sure that she's really confident with us, so that when she gets to the Breakers, she's nice and ready to go. And then she'll spend another 2 weeks inside a racing kennel to get ready for what life's gonna be like as a racing greyhound before she goes to the Breakers. And then at the end of May, she'll head over to Ballarat to spend 4 to 6 weeks with Peter Gavin to be broken in, ready for racing. So she's looking beautiful, really happy with her. She's got a lovely shiny coat on her, and no issues other than lots of work to do, really. So we'll keep you posted along the way, guys.